In this video, I want to teach you how you can still lead when your followers are discouraged and doubt you as a leader. What's up, YouTube family? Welcome back to the channel. This is Alex Suber, and I am so thankful that you're here. I post content to help you grow in your faith, your life, and your leadership. I really believe all of those are kind of cohesive and all roll into one, so I hope it helps you in all those areas, but at least one of them. If you're new, thank you so much for clicking on this video. I'm gonna dive straight into the content because I know your time is valuable. So here we go. Let's talk about how you can still lead when your followers are discouraged and doubt your leadership. We're gonna go to Exodus chapter 6, and I don't always do this. I don't always use a Bible passage to teach leadership, but I think you have to understand, if you're on my channel, I'm open. I'm a Jesus guy. I love Jesus. And I believe that there are some incredible leadership principles that can be found in the Bible if you look at it from that lens, if you're trying to hear from God on how you can be a better leader. So this is Moses in the book of Exodus chapter 6, and Moses is trying to rescue his people from slavery. If you're not familiar with the Bible, his people have been enslaved to the Egyptians for over 400 years, and now he feels like it is his call, his mandate, his purpose in life to lead them out of that captivity and to the promised land that God has for them. So as Exodus chapter 6, starting in verse 6, "Therefore say to the people of Israel," this is God speaking to Moses, "I am the Lord. I will free you from your oppression. I will rescue from the slavery of Egypt. I will redeem you with a powerful arm and great acts of judgment. I will claim you as my own people, and I will be your God. Then you will know that I am the Lord your God and have freed you from your oppression in Egypt. I will bring you into the land I swore to give to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So I will give you your very own possessions. I am the Lord." Now, that's a huge promise. Like, that is an incredible promise. Who would not have that? Who would not want that? Like, that's the greatest Vision Sunday sermon series ever. Like, all of these incredible things are about to happen. But now let's go to the next verse. Have you ever had just a great vision? Like, you think you have this great idea, and then you share it with someone, and this is what happens. The next verse. "So Moses told the people of Israel what God said, but they refused to listen anymore. They became too discouraged by the brutality of their slavery. They were too discouraged by the brutality of their slavery. Then the Lord said to Moses, 'Go back to Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, and tell him to let the people of Israel leave his country.'" Now, God is telling Moses, go do the vision, even though the people aren't wanting to follow you. That's a key right there. Go do what I've called you to do, even though the people are discouraged. "But Lord," Moses objected, "my own people won't listen to me anymore. My own family, my own team, my own department, they won't listen to me anymore. How can I expect someone else to listen if even my own people won't listen? How can I expect Pharaoh to listen? And I'm such a clumsy speaker." Moses, he was not a good speaker. He had a speech impediment. "But the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron and gave them orders for the Israelites and for Pharaoh, the king of Egypt. And the Lord commanded Moses and Aaron to lead the people out of Egypt." So he said, even though you have these complaints, even though you have these problems, even though your people are discouraged, your team is discouraged, I'm still calling you to do the same vision. I'm still calling you to do the same thing that I told you before. Just because circumstances have changed, just because people are discouraged, just because you got your budget cut, or just because COVID came in, or just because you lost that bid, or that influential family left your church, just because something has happened doesn't mean the vision has changed. Doesn't mean the vision has changed. So how do you practically lead something, lead a ministry, lead a youth group, lead a church, lead a business, lead your family, whatever it may be? How do you lead that when your followers are discouraged, when even your own followers won't do what you want to do? Forget other people, forget the Egyptians. The Egyptians represent the people that are against you, the things that you're fighting against. Forget trying to fight against those. You're fighting against your own people right now. So how are you supposed to do what God's called you to do? Well, here's the first thing I think you need to understand. As a leader, you have to know what people need, not what people want. As a leader, you have to know what people need, not what people want. Henry Ford has a great quote, and I'm not even sure if he actually said it, you know, these quotes on the internet, but it's great either way. He says, if I would have listened to what people wanted, they would have said faster horses. Now, we know Henry Ford is the one that really made cars popular and accessible with the Model T and those different things. And so if he would have listened to them in his time, they would have said, hey, figure out how to make faster horses. Figure out how to make a faster carriage. Figure out how to do something that we're already doing just better. And he said, no, I'm not going to listen to what you want. I'm going to look beyond that and look what you need. I'm going to look to the future. You may not even realize you need it right now, but I am looking to your future. And so as a leader, especially if you're a spiritual leader, if you're a pastor, if you're a minister, if you're a youth group leader, small group leader, whatever it may be, you have to look at what people need, not necessarily what they want. And so in this story, Moses' followers, his people, they did not want to leave because they did not want to be burdened anymore. They knew that the Egyptians would punish them if they tried to escape. And so they said, we don't want to even try to escape because we don't want things to get worse. Have you ever felt like that as a leader before? We don't want to try anything new. We don't want to push any harder. We don't want to try any new strategies or anything else because we've already been burned so many times and it's easier and it's less painful and it's just, it's better that we just stay. Even though it's not good, let's just stay where we are right now. So as a leader, you have to refuse and you have to say, I'm sorry. I know that you want to stay comfortable in your captivity. Come on, that's a preacher statement right there. I know you want to stay comfortable in this situation, but I know what you need. You need freedom. You need to not be a slave anymore. You need to step into all the things that God has promised you. And so people may not want to do what you feel they are supposed to do, but you have to look at what they need, not what they want. The second thing that Moses did is he had at least one follower that was with him. There's a super old school YouTube video. I'll try to see if I can link it in the comments or in the description, but it's the principle of the first follower. And there's so much psychology behind if you can get one person that truly believes in you and believes in your vision, believes in your leadership, it is amazing how once that first domino goes over, I know you've seen all of these examples before, it's incredible what that first domino can affect and can do. And so maybe in this season right now, when you're facing these things and people are discouraged, people are heartbroken, people don't want to follow you, they're doubting you, maybe don't focus on everyone, but find someone or a few people that you know you can turn around and you know you can get on your side. Because say you're trying to get 50 people, a huge team or a huge ministry, whatever it may be, and you're trying to convince all of them, it's not going to work. You need to focus down and say, okay, where are my influencers? Where are the people that I know I can impact? I know I can change their mind, and focus on getting those first few people to follow you, because then it's just going to be a domino effect. They're going to have influence on people. People are going to start to trust you again as a leader. They're going to begin to talk about all the incredible things that you're doing. It's not just going to be you talking about it. It's going to be other people talking about it. And so I would encourage you, if people are discouraged, if people are frustrated right now, don't focus on everybody. Don't focus on the big group. Focus on just a few people, even if it's just one person, and begin to turn that around. And I guarantee you that it's going to get easier as you progress. That first person is going to be the hardest, but once you can get them on your side, then it's going to be a domino effect. And you're going to get the rest of the group, the rest of the team to follow behind you and do what you feel called to do. And then the last thing is, we're going through this, I hope this is helping you, how to get someone to follow you when they're discouraged, when they don't trust you as a leader. Here's the thing, you have to stick with the vision. Whatever the vision you have is, you have to realize that there are going to be hard times. There are going to be times where people doubt you, where they don't want to follow you. There are going to be times when the resources dry up. There's going to be times like when this video is being filmed right now in 2021, where we still don't know what's happening with COVID and the shutdowns and all these different things. There are going to be things that come against you, but you have to stick with the vision. Because as the leader, you are the one that is responsible for carrying the vision. Yes, you want other people to carry it with you, but ultimately it comes down to you. If you don't believe in the vision, no one else is going to believe in the vision. If you don't believe God can do it, no one else is going to believe God can do it. If you don't have faith for it, no one else is going to have faith for it. And so you have to stick with the vision, even when people doubt you, when you doubt yourself. Moses is saying, hey, I've got a speech impediment. Pharaoh's not going to listen to me. My own people won't even listen to me. What am I supposed to do, God? And God says, stick with the vision. Go to Pharaoh and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. the same thing I told you when you were back in the day and you thought you had it all together and you thought you were the best leader ever and you thought you had all the resources and you thought this was going to be easy. The same thing I taught you back then, the same thing I spoke to you back then, I want you to do that same thing now. You've got to stick with the vision. You've got to believe in yourself. You've got to believe in what you know is true. I know it doesn't really make sense, but there's a great quote that says, even when the facts don't line up, you have to know the truth. Even when the facts are going against you, you have to know what is true. I know you're like, that probably doesn't even make sense. Maybe not. But here's the thing. Even when things are stacked against you, you have to believe in yourself and say, I'm going to believe the truth that I'm going to get through this. I'm going to believe the truth that we're going to overcome this. And so just to wrap it all up, I know I've been kind of real excited in this, but this is something I'm going through right now with our team, with our church, with our vision there that we're trying to build a building right now and it's not happening. We're trying to grow the church right now and so many things with COVID and all this stuff. But here's the thing, just to recap really quickly, you can't give people what they want. You have to give people what they need. You have to know what people need. And you're like, I don't know what they need. Well, one, if you are a Christian leader, I believe that you need to search the Word of God and you need to talk with God. You need to pray and you need to figure out what they need. Or maybe just look at practical situations. How can I look at the things that they're going through, the struggles that they're having right now, and how can I help fix those issues? How can I see what they need? So you have to know what people need, not what they want. And then you also have to get one follower. Just get one follower. Get a few people behind you. Don't worry about getting the whole church yet. Don't worry about getting the whole youth group yet. Just get your leadership team fired up. Get your assistant pastor fired up. Get your CFO fired up. Get your day shift manager fired up. Whatever it may be, get that first person fired up, and then it's going to begin to spill over into other people. And then lastly, you got to stick with the vision. No matter how hard it gets, no matter how rough it gets, no matter how many people come against you, how many issues you have, no matter how much even you doubt yourself, you have to stick with the vision. I hope this has helped you during this time. I know right now it's hard to be a leader, and you probably have a lot of people that are discouraged and a lot of people that are doubting you, but I believe that you can make it through this. If you use these principles, you can make it through any tough situation. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you're still sticking around, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell notification. It helps me get this message, these principles out to more people. You know, the YouTube algorithm, it scans everything, and so it knows what you are doing on my channel. So make sure you interact, drop a comment, whatever you want to do. I would love to interact with you. You can follow me on Instagram, DM me there. I'd love to answer any questions that you have. And then probably right around now in this video, there are some other videos popping up. And so you can click on one of those and continue to watch some content on my channel. Again, I hope this helps you grow in your faith, your life, and your leadership. I'm always putting out more content. So I hope you check back, and I'll see you next time.